Jethro Muhlala, or is it Lovers Muhlala, is a South African former footballer who played professionally as a left back. A little bit more later on in the video on that first name drama. Now, Lovers played his football in South Africa. He also played abroad in Greece, as well as played for the South African national team Bafana Bafana. Now, before we go any further in this video, if you are new to this glorious channel and haven't subscribed, do hit that red subscribe button, hit the bell notification to be notified of future uploads. With that said, hello and welcome to Red Live. Lovers was born on the 26th of April 1975 in Alexandra. He started his football senior career at Wits University in 1992 and stayed with Wits until 1997. Now, when it comes to his first name and all the ID drama, according to the reports in the early stages of his football career while still at Wits University FC, the versatile left back Muhlala was known as Jethro, but later on reports surfaced that he was using someone else's name. Now, Muhlala spoke to kickoff.com about the name issue and said the following: "Remember, there was a story that I stole somebody's ID. There was a court case. I was taken to court. You see, it's good that I need to give somebody an opportunity to write about something that was speculation. I was from Northwest. All my stuff was in Northwest. When I started school, they wouldn't want a birth certificate. And when they made a tournament, my certificate was nowhere to be found. And the process was long and my mother was working then. To get the certificate, your parent needed to accompany you. Without a parent, you wouldn't get a certificate. Eventually, the discussion between my family and my cousin, I don't know what took place, but I ended up using my cousin's name." But anyways, he went on to say, "There was a time I was in the national team somewhere, and eventually I didn't go because I was forced to take the passport in his name. Now, what I did is that I had to get my own certificate. You know, when you play in those leagues, people will ask you, 'But you were this one, now you are this one.'" Now, with the name that he actually used in the PSL, Muhlala said the following: "I was never registered as Jethro Muhlala at the PSL. I was always registered as Lovers. You can check with the PSL. Jethro was a cousin." So there you have it, folks. The first name confusion. According to those reports, he was using his cousin's first name and his cousin's ID. Now, during the court case where it was found that the age on Lovers' ID was different from Jethro's ID, which is his cousin, so the whole soccer players using different ages on their ID isn't so far-fetched. And those that are suspected to be doing it as of right now, they're not the first. But going back to that interview that he had with kickoff.com, Lovers did say that he was not the only one that was doing this. Now, when it comes to the case, eventually the court threw out the case. Now, let us take a look at him joining Mamelodi Sundowns. Lovers went on to join Mamelodi Sundowns in 1997. However, he has revealed that he was actually on his way to join Kaizer Chiefs. He said the following about his move to Sundowns: "While I was on my way to Kaizer Chiefs, Sundowns called me and I went to Sundowns. My heart was not with Chiefs. Wits wanted 300,000 for me." Now, when it comes to money, it is reported that his salary at Sundowns was 12,000 rands, and this is a jump up from his salary of 5,000 rands that was reported with his previous team Wits. So his move to Mamelodi Sundowns actually saw him earn over double what he was earning at Wits. Now, looking at his time at Mamelodi Sundowns, he was part of the all-conquering Sundowns team that won 3 Castle Premiership titles in 1998, 1999, as well as 2000. So going off that, it does seem that his decision to join Sundowns over Kaizer Chiefs definitely did pay off. Now, at the time, one could say that his on-field decisions were definitely very much wise. However, his off-field decisions, though, seemed to be a little bit unwise. There were reports at the time that he had been living a flashy footballer's lifestyle, complete with showy BMWs and questionable behaviors. He was also on the news for all the wrong reasons during this time. Talking about some off-field behavior, Lovers revealed the following incident: "There was a time I was late for camping at Sundowns and I claimed I was kidnapped. I took a gun and shot my techie, claiming it was shot by kidnappers. I wonder which coach fell for that." But anyways, taking a look at the other clubs that he played for, in 2003, following a failed move to FC Copenhagen, Lovers forced a move from Sundowns to AmaZulu, though shortly after his move, he re-signed with Wits University, and then he moved to Jomo Cosmos. In January of 2004, Lovers signed with Greece Super League side Aris Thessaloniki. He only made just 2 league appearances for the club before returning to South Africa after 6 months. He then played for Jomo Cosmos in 2004 to 2005. He played for Silver Stars in 2005 till 2006. He played for Moroka Swallows in 2006 to 2007. He played for AmaZulu in 2007 to 2008. He played for Black Leopards in 2008 to 2009. And Lovers would retire in 2009. Taking a look at Lovers' national team career, Lovers Mohlala actually represented South Africa from under 17 to under 23. He went on to make 9 appearances for Bafana Bafana senior team. His debut was in the 1999 COSAFA Cup match against Botswana. So what happened to Lovers Mohlala? After living a perceived flashy footballer's lifestyle and changing woman, Lovers recently spoke about how he went broke after football. He said the following, "I went broke, my chief, after football. I went broke. I didn't have anything, I didn't have a car, I got broke after 3 months. Now in 2014, reports linked Lovers Mohlala with a job at Glocorp. He was expected to return to his former club as one of their scouts. Lovers Mohlala was also involved with the South Africa Football Players Union. But looking at more recent reports, Lovers says that he has turned his life around and is a cattle farmer who owns a soccer academy. He said the following about his latest ventures. "The soccer academy is supported by Glencore Mine. I do motivations even though people don't want to pay me. I have done it with Platinum Stars, Bloemfontein Celtics and Sundowns. Sundowns have committed themselves to actually assessing my players anytime whenever I see a good player. There's a guy by the name of Thembiso Njangase. I met him in 1993 and he's making things happen for me." Lovers went on to say in that interview, "You see, sometimes in life, we should tell these players, former teams should call us to speak with these kids before they sign them for the PSL. To tell them what are the challenges of playing in the PSL or being in the limelight. Tell them how we spent our money and what we have now. That would definitely be a great initiative, and it has been done by teams in the PSL and outside of the PSL from time to time, bringing in former players to motivate and tell them about life and all the troubles and challenges that they went through and have gone through." But going back to Lovers, Lovers has been a very outspoken figure in soccer. He has spoken out about PSL clubs' treatment of retired players. He said the following, "Retired SA players have to beg for match tickets. We are being treated like we did not contribute or play a role. Look at my Facebook profile. I am not happy. If you look overseas, players like Didier Drogba are still getting important seats in the VIP section. They still recognized and respected. But here in South Africa, you find soapy stars and slay queens in the VIP sections. Those people did not play football. It is safe to say that slay queens have a horrible reputation. I mean, even former football players are talking bad about them." But at least Lovers didn't throw his former club Sundowns under the bus. He said the following, "I'm going to be honest, Sundowns are still giving me nice tickets when I ask, but what about other players? What about Bafana Bafana matches? I played for South Africa under 23s and the senior national team, but you find TV stars and actors in the VIP suits. Why can't we be like England and honor former players? Because we always see former players being treated nicely. The other day, a club owner walked into the VIP suit and he didn't even greet me. I felt very bad, like I didn't belong there." I will say I hear what he is saying about the treatment of former football players here in South Africa, and I wish the legendary Sundowns left back all the best in his future endeavors. But yeah, that is the end of the video. If you enjoyed it, do give it a huge thumbs up. Also comment down below and let me know what you guys think about what he was saying about the treatment of former football players in South Africa as compared to football players, former football players in other leagues like in England. And as always, thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to Real Live if you haven't and binge watch my previous videos.